We are at Sura, a brand new Thai restaurant out in DuPont Circle. Let's get into it. The crying tiger skewers, mad juicy and tossed in loads of seasoning. As you can see from my face, I enjoyed this one. Maybe a little too much. Next is the quail egg wonton. Had a little trouble biting this thing, but tasty nonetheless. Papaya salad. If you love spicy and pickled food, this one is for you. Thai people eat it with pork rinds. Not gonna lie, totally smacks with the Thai chicharrones. Fried bean curd. Tasted like a crispy meatball. Would totally eat this again. The salmon and shrimp crudo. If y'all vibe with ceviche, definitely worth getting these. For entrees, we got this Thai cashew chicken. Sounds basic, but this one was actually our favorite dish of the night. Each piece of chicken was insanely caramelized, a savory sweet masterpiece. Lastly, this curry egg sauce situation topped with shrimp. Rich and buttery, not sleep on this one. We actually came here twice, so stay tuned for part two. We are back with Sura part 2. Yo, did you guys know that Singha makes sparkling water? This joint hits like Topo Chico. The carbonation is on steroids. Shout out to Andy behind the bar for putting us on. And make sure you check out his Thai-inspired cocktails. Onto the food, we had these shrimp crackers with peanut sauce. Now, we grew up eating shrimp crackers, but never with peanut sauce. So this was very different, yet also very enjoyable. The fried calamari with sweet chili. If you want a safe choice, this one is for you. Where are my pork belly fans at? Wok fried pork belly, doused in garlic and herb. Spicy, just the way I like it. Next up, we got this pasta concoction. This is like Italy and Thailand had a baby. I can't even describe this flavor to be honest, but it was one half grazie grazie and one half kap kum kap. The pad thai. Not your ordinary pad thai, as it comes with shredded mango and the noodles are extra soaked with pad thai flavor. Finally, the desserts. Yo, this is a creme brulee grapefruit. Now, I didn't know how to feel about this one, but Diana loves grapefruit. It was a bit too out of pocket for me, but maybe you guys will enjoy it. The fried banana, on the other hand, is definitely something I vibe with. All of Southeast Asia has their own version of this, so it was a very comforting flavor. Hope you guys enjoyed that food adventure at Sura, and we'll catch you at DuPont Circle.